So the first thing you look for is the mechanism of injury. If someone's going for a mark and they land from a height onto their forearms, that's obviously quite a significant amount of force into their arm as opposed to just getting their hand caught in someone's jumper. So that's the first thing we look for. The second thing is how sore they are. Athletes are very good at knowing their own bodies, and if something's extremely sore, there's a good chance that there might be a broken bone. And then secondly, by the time we get them off the field, assessing that injury, if it's already swollen and it's very tender to press on, there's a good chance that something's broken. Whereas if they come off, it hurts, but it's not too swollen, it's not that tender to actually press on, then maybe it's just a ligament injury or a muscle contusion as opposed to a broken bone. Generally speaking, if we have strong index of suspicion that someone might have a broken bone, we'll send them to hospital. Not all broken bones are the same. If someone breaks their leg or their thigh bone, then that's obviously a pretty significant injury and they tend to be not even brought off the ground. They'll go straight to hospital via ambulance. But if someone thinks they might have a broken hand, depending on how sore they are, depending on how swollen they are, we can often wait till the next day to get x-rays. But if they are pretty sore and swollen, then we'll send them to hospital that night. So generally you don't want to have a full cast on at the time of injury, because with a broken bone there's going to be lots of swelling, and if you put a firm complete 360 cast on, that will just compress that swelling, and that generally leads to a fair bit of extra pain.